Salutations, Internet, and welcome back to DeWombat Gaming. I'm DeWombat, and we are still playing Baldur's Gate, Tales of the Sword Coast. In the last episode, I got very frustrated with the game, because Imogen died to wolves, and I had to load, and I don't want her to die, because she's a thief and important, and yeah, stuff like that. But in this episode, hopefully things will go better. Hopefully. Yeah. We'll see. Diseased Gibberling. Alright, kill that. I killed it. With one hit. Good. Xar, let's not have you rushing over because you're not that amazing.
Stand ready.
Go ahead, switch to your sword. Alright. That Gibberling exploded. Let's make sure that we have enough arrows equipped, shall we? There we go. Wear that ring. Give that gem to Imogen, because gems weigh almost nothing. Okay, continue on our merry way. Let's explore, let's explore. Yeah. We killed that ogre last episode and got those belts, so that's nice. I promise not to get as angry as last time. Well, I guess I can't promise that. If something goes wrong, and I'm really annoyed.
If I must.
No, Imogen. Use your bow.
Something
you derp.
Yep, I'm gone.
You derpy butt.
Yes?
And kill him. Kill him. Kill. There we go.
Not a problem. I stand.
All right,
not a
pick
problem.
Up their stuff. A gem and a sword. Another sword. Give the gem to Imogen. You know what? Give the scroll to Imogen. Give the dagger to Imogen. She can carry all the light stuff. All right. Let's quick save. Because I just don't want to risk having to load all the time. So after every fight, we're going to quick save. That's just, I gotta get in that habit, because I know something terrible's gonna happen. We'll continue, we're exploring, more Exvart. Shoot him.
Yes? I stand ready.
Shoot the Exvart. Xar just sort of.
Not a problem.
Alright, chase that. Oh, more Exvarts, alright. Xar, no.
It will be done.
My blade will cut you down to size.
Raise your sword. Come on. Kill him.
What do you want? I've done had enough of this.
Yes?
Just hit him. Just hit him with the sword. Come on. You've got 18. There you go.
I stand ready.
And kill that one.
My blade will cut you down to size.
When they have the yellow around them, that means they're scared and are not very capable of doing things. And as you saw, that one was too scared to even fight. To even run. He was just sitting there. Like an idiot. Pick up all the stuff. Gold. Delightful. Keep exploring. This looks like a cliff. Is there anything over this part of the world? Oh, quick save! Gotta remember to quick. You guys, remind me to quick save. Should've quick saved. Gotta quick save. Quick save. Alright, there's nothing over here. Let's go over here, past the Exvart corpses, the exploded Exvart corpse. What is an Exvart? I think I'm gonna look that up and let you guys know next episode, because that's. That's weird. It's weird. I don't know what Exvarts are. They're things. They're silly little blue. They're like Smurfs. That's it. They probably live in mushrooms. Some wizard named Gargamel is trying to kill them and cook them. Makes the most sense. I think. Wouldn't you agree? Yeah. Let's let's have our bow out, shall we?
I stand ready.
Yeah, okay.
It will be done.
Friendly Armin to the north, Bergos to the south, Lion's Way west to Candlekeep. More Exvarts and Gibberlings, okay. I don't appreciate them targeting Imogen. She doesn't have a high enough armor class.
Yes.
Who just said attack? Because that Exart did not. Alright, I bet we can... Yeah, alright. Good. Good. Kill him. Alright.
It will be done.
Everything's delightful. I find it interesting that the Exvarts only give me 15 experience, when the Gibberlings give me 35.
I stand ready.
And yet Gibberlings are easier to kill.
Yes?
That seems backwards to me. I can't pick up any more swords. Can Imogen carry one more sword? What's that mean? I'm not sure what that means. I wish Imogen was stronger so she could carry things.
It will be done.
I think that makes her slower. Let's see. Also, AI on.
Yes.
She doesn't look too slow. Alright, let's continue. Lion's Way. Coastway. Oh, okay. So that's just the name of that road. Quick save! I remembered the quick save. I almost forgot, though. I told you guys to remember me! To remind me, not to remember. Remember me, fondly. If I die, so be it. Remember me. Let's go through the trees, past this rock, past this rock, past all of the rocks, back onto the road, and then off of the road. We're exploring the wilderness. All of the wilderness. Don't see anything. Nope, nope, nope. More diseased gibberlings, alrighty. Shoot them. Not Uxar.
I stand ready.
They're so easy to kill. I guess they're just free experience, basically.
Yes.
And alright, Imogen, go ahead and use your sword.
Stand ready.
You can use your sword.
It will be done.
Just swing at it. Come on. Kill it. There we... Did Imogen do that? I can't tell which one of us made it explode.
You're a queer
fellow. Use your bow.
Yes?
Continue. Diseased gibberlings never carry any loot. Only not diseased gibberlings can carry loot, apparently. Oh, for a second I thought I couldn't get up there. I thought this was a cliff face. Although it looks like that is just a cliff, so nothing up there. Yeah, alright. Let's continue to the left. Onwards to the left.
To the left.
Hi. If you don't mind, please try to keep your voices down. There'll be beasties about with better hearing than we. You seem quite at home out here. What's the most dangerous thing you've seen? The most dangerous thing I intentionally went after? Stalked an ogre mage for a few days once. Had a party of my own back then. Killed the ogre, lost the party. Not really worth the trade, if you ask me. I've seen more dangerous beasties, but usually over my shoulder as I'm making tracks as fast as I can. No shame in running when your life is on the line. Off with you now. I've meat to catch. Okay, I guess that guy's just a hunter, giving us advice that we can run away from fights. You do not have to fight everything you come across. But where's the fun in that? I already fought an ogre. I guess he's a retired adventurer. Gibberling.
Onward!
Gibberling.
I stand ready. It will be done.
If I must.
There we go. Dead gibberlings are dead gibberlings. We get so much experience from gibberlings. Quick save. I don't think I quick saved after that last fight, guys. You are not doing a very good job of reminding me. It's all your fault. Now, isn't this the spot where there were wolves and Imogen died? Where are they? Where are the wolves? No, I didn't miss anything. Alright, whatever. We're almost done exploring the area. Friendly arm in to the north, but there's still a teeny bit of blackness, and then we'll go north. Just a teeny bit left. And then we can do stuff in a town. So that'll be nice. Is there anybody at all up here on this cliff? Anything at all? No? No. Onwards. Continue. There's more stuff up here than I thought. Like, more room, I mean. Alright, let's venture onwards. To the Friendly Arm Inn. Looks more like a fortress than an inn to me. Look at that! It's a castle! And the journey took 8 hours, which means it is dark at the moment. Let's hurry in. Quick save. Hello, guards. Welcome to the Friendly Arm Inn. I trust you know the rules of conduct within. What rules? Alright, cool. Don't do anything mean to people. Basically, is what he's saying. It's a neutral place. Let's go. Commoner. So he's not important. Well, I guess that's sort of mean. Commoners aren't important!
Yes?
More commoners and a guard. I believe this is the inn right here. So let's go up it.
Hi, friend.
Hi. Tarnish. Hi, friend. I've not seen you here before today. What brings you to the Friendly Arm? I'm here to meet some friends. Oh, you must be whom I am to meet, then. I will take you to your friends. But first, I should be sure you are the correct person. Is your name Sir Wombat? Yeah. Perfect. You are indeed the person I seek. Hold still a moment, won't you? He's casting spells.
Yes?
Okay, that's not good.
Not a problem.
I care not.
Let's sword him.
I've done had enough of this.
You?
He cast mirror image. He's casting spells. Imowen is afraid, and so is Xar. Alright. And I died. Alright. Let's load, shall we? I was aware that he was going to do that. And often you will die there, because he is hard to kill. But it's necessary. That's also why I quicksaved at the beginning of the Friendly Arm. So let's try saving right before talking to him, and let's try fighting him again. Seems like a good idea.
Not a problem.
Oh, everybody go. No need to talk to the guard again. Onwards. I think Imowen should just stick with her bow, because I think she's better at hitting stuff with her bow than she is with swords.
Heya.
But that's what Imowen says. Don't take her thing. Heya, it's me, Imowen. Whenever I hear that, it makes me feel good. It's one of those nostalgia things. It's like hearing the initial Mario NES music. Quick save. Let's go up and talk to that bitch.
Hi, friend.
What happens if we say other things?
Hi, friend.
I'm not your friend, and my business is my own. How rude. No, really, that is utterly rude of you. I'd teach you a lesson about manners, but that implies that you're going to live. If I weren't going to anyway, I'd kill you just for being so uppity. Right, alright. So,
I stand
he still wants
not
to kill
problem.
Us.
Yep. I'm gone.
Something troubling you?
And,
hardly
sure.
With my time.
Xar can help. If only I could hit him. Alright, all of us are feared. We've been panicked. And I died again. Alright, lovely. Not sure what to do here. Besides, just keep trying until we can do it. Oh, I clicked logout. My bad. Alright, well now you'll see what I do to get into the game. Create game. Load game. The game takes a little bit to get into the loading screen. Come on. Come on. There we go. Load quick save. Do. And let's get rid of him.
Not a problem.
Hi, friend.
Yeah, come down here, where there might be guards to help us. I'm here to meet some friends. Nothing much, really, just road-worn travelers looking for a place to rest. Pardon my being too forward, but you've the bearing of someone I've been looking for. About your height, they were. Same style of dress, or thereabouts. I dare say you seem to be the spitting image of them. Might you have traveled from Candlekeep by any chance? Never heard of it. I would beg to differ. You fit the description, so I think it would be safe to assume you're the one I seek. Don't move, I have something for you. You have a spell.
Yes?
Jerk.
Not a problem.
And I'd be... Yeah, this guard is going to help. All right. That's better. Let's see if we can't get him. Come on! I've been feared. But Imowen wasn't. Kill the damn guy! Come on! Imowen's dead. Of course. No. 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 We're gonna do this until it works. I promise you. I guess we're gonna see every different thing that he can say. Also, what was that noise? Was that him dying? Done.
Hi, friend.
Hi, friend.
Yes?
Have your sword out.
I stand ready.
I'm here to meet some friends. I don't think you're the person I'm supposed to meet. I would beg to differ. You fit the description? Okay, I guess that's just what he says every time. Attack, please?
Onward!
We just have to hit him. Come on. Okay, he only... Oh, I hit him once. And he has morale! Okay, we did it. We did it.
Yes, with ease.
Alright, good. And he has a bunch of scrolls and stuff. Let's drop... I believe short swords are worth the least. So let's just exchange short swords for these things. Doo-dee-doo.
I stand ready.
Alright. Let's quick save. Now that we finally got past that jerk. Oh, and I should probably read that scroll that he dropped. Bounty notice. Be it known to all those of evil intent that a bounty has been placed upon the head of Sir Wombat, the foster child of Gorion. Last seen in the area of Candlekeep, this person is to be killed in quick order. Those returning with proof of the deed shall receive no less than 200 coins of gold. As always, any that reveal these plans to the forces of law shall join the target in their fate. Guard? Oh. Can I tell you about this? There's to be no fighting or stealing within sight of the... Okay, I guess I don't have anything to tell him. Besides the fact that I just tried... Some guy tried to murder me.
Not a problem.
Hey, friend. Good to meet a fine sod such as yourself.
I can't stand the way the roads are cut off these days. My uncle is in Baldur's Gate, and I can't get up there to see him. How come the roads are cut off? Where you been these past few months? The roads are crawling with brigands and bandits after every scrap of iron you got on ye. Surely you must have fled some on your trip here. Lest you came by the west road, that is. Well, for this, I hope the roads are clear up soon. I'll see you around. Well, I sure ain't going nowheres.
Yes?
Jopey. Welp.
What's up?
You need some ale, whelp?
Yes?
That? Oh, it's Khalid and Jahira! Hey, you guys! Hey!
Calm yourself, dear. We must proceed carefully.
Something about you is familiar, child. Your manner reminds me of a sage I know, by the name of Gorion. It is almost a slight on him, but I see it too. Jahira, mind your manners! This must be the child that Gorion wrote of so often. We are old friends of your adopted father. He is not with you? I must assume the worst. He would not permit his only child to wander without his accompaniment. If he has passed, we share your loss. Gorion often said that he worried for your safety, even at the expense of his own. He also wished that Khalid and I would become your guardians if he should ever meet an untimely end. However, you are much older now, and the choice of your companion should be your own. We could to travel with you until you get settled. Hope you find your lot in life. It would be a fitting last service to Gorion, though we should first go to Nashkel. Khalid and I Look into local concerns, and there are rumors of strange things happening at the mine. No doubt you have heard of the iron shortage? You would do well to help us. It affects everyone, including you. We are to meet the mayor of the town, Baron Gastkill. I'm already going to Nashville. One of my current acquaintances wishes to visit there as well. Indeed? Interesting. In that case, I think we should definitely travel as one. You can never be too careful about the dangers on the open road, wherever they may spring from. All right.
Yes.
So now we have a full party, including dead Montaran. Probably should revive him. So we have a necromancer, a fighter thief who's dead, a thief, a fighter druid, and a fighter. So we just have a lot of fighters. Fighter druid, huh? That's interesting. With a potion of invisibility, and just a fighter. And he has a shield, and good armor, and a helmet, even. I need to get a helmet. Also, I'm a fighter mage. Ooh! Okay, let's sell stuff, shall we? To Bentley Mirror Shade.
Can I help you? You have need of me?
What do you have to sell? Let's get rid of all these stuff I don't need. Okay. Gems. I don't really need Orion's scroll anymore. Leather armor's only worth one gold piece. Probably should have just not picked those up. I'll remember that for next time. Okie dokie. Alright. Now, let's take off our armor. Oh, not him. Me. Take off our armor. And try writing these into our spellbook. But, first, quick save. Alright. Write magic. Failed. That one worked. Eh. I'm okay with that. I'm never going to cast armor anyway. And we can just sell that one, I think. Or we could try and teach it to Xar. He failed because he's dumb. Alright, whatever. I guess I really didn't need to quick save because I don't care. Oh. Huh. Alright, let's... I have lots of gold now. Let's look at stuff that we could better equip ourselves with. We've got better bows. A better sword for me. That's good. Let's get a better bow. What's a composite longbow do? I guess they're just better, so let's get one. There we go. Let's look at what Jahira is good with. Proficiencies. She's good with blunt weapons and missile weapons. Alright, good. Missile weapons means she's good with darts and slings, so we'll give her a sling. And Khalid is good with large swords, bow, and axe. So we'll get him a better bow, probably. And are you good with anything, Xar? Oh, you're good with small swords. Well, I already sold all those. Whatever. Alright. Does this count as a blunt weapon? Yeah. Let's see if we can't get you a better blunt weapon, though.
With ease. It's been dreadful slow business.
Also, let's buy some slings and some bullets. Sling. Sling. How good are warhammers? Yeah, warhammers aren't very good, even... Yeah, they should be better, but they're not. Let's buy a longbow. Sell that short bow. Let's get some bullets, if we can. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. And she can wear better armor. Perhaps we should get her some. He's already got splint. We could give her splint. And Xar doesn't use any. She's already got studded leather, I think, because we took that from Montaran's body. Let's get a shield. And probably a shield for Jahira, because she can use one. Oh, it looks like I had highlighted splint mail. Oh well. Well, I was gonna get some anyway. Give that. Give that. We're gonna have Kzarm mostly using his sling, because that makes the most sense. And I think this episode has more than likely gone on long enough, don't you? I'd say so. There we go. Jahira looks much more fighty now. Yep. Alright, yes. So we finally made it to the Friendly Arm. We met up with Jahira and Khalid. That's a good time had by all. I hope you enjoyed it. Click the like button if you liked it. Subscribe for more videos. I update all the time. And I will see you guys next time.